materials are my words, you know, like the stuff that I put the idea together with. They all have their own understanding, you know, expression. You can look them up in the dictionary almost. They have a meaning, they have a weight, they have a, you know, they have qualities, an understanding that is what I use when I sort of put them into play with the idea. Yeah, sometimes it's an idea in search of a material, sometimes it's a material in search of an idea. If you look around this studio, you'll see plenty of those pathways, you know, kind of look like they're going somewhere, but they, you know, they might be dead ends. They might just be sort of sitting out their time before I scrape them off into a box and sort of put them away, or they might just be sitting right on the edge of completion. It's gathering the words together, and then I might end up with a sentence, you know, that makes some sort of sense. The idea of it being useful, of being it applied, is why I've sort of, you know, stuck with this particular field. It's, you know, every time somebody tells me that I make beautiful small sculptures, I have to remind them, you know, they're not small for the reason that, you know, they want to be small sculptures. They're small because they're answering to the demands of, you know, weight and wearability. I work on my own in this space. There's no to and fro going on. That to and fro doesn't happen until the work finds the owner. Somehow the owner is always, you know, sitting on my shoulder, whether it's the owner of work that I've made or the work that I'm making. It doesn't matter, but they do have a voice in the conversation, and I think that's what accepts the visual, I mean, accepts the applied arts from the wider fine arts, visual arts, is that responsibility. What has identity got to do with jewellery? Well, absolutely everything. It's the identity of the wearer that becomes critical to the understanding of jewellery. Where does that image that, you know, that really kind of strong image of the tiki fit into our visual arts culture? I'll sort of remind you that it's a piece of jewellery. So the version I did was pulling in the image, but it pulled it right into a totally European framework. It's the tiki sitting claws. There are so many different pressures now that shape us sort of culturally. That moment that I was working in the 1980s, in a way, was like a tiny bubble compared to the environment now. You'd still have to say identity is the concern, but I think what I've done, and it could be something to do with getting older too, is that the identity is sort of, rather than expand, rather than become global, has become quite personal. And I've tended to create the interest around, I suppose, myself and myself as a maker, you know, what I've inherited from my own history. What are the things that I've become good at? What are the things that I can still be good at? Is there something, you know, completely new out there? The idea of exploring that kind of relationship to making has become sort of quite central to, you know, to what gets made. Yeah.